pleased to convene a forum on H.R. 40, the Commission to Study Reparation Proposals for African Americans during this 44th Annual Legislative Conference of the Congressional Black Caucus. This year marks the 25th year of this bill's introduction since I first introduced it in 1989. We've made substantial progress in elevating this issue in the national consciousness through state and local resolutions, litigation. We're moving closer to a full dialogue on the role of slavery and how to formally address one of our greatest historical injustices. Today there are more people at the table, more activists, more scholars, more CEOs, more state and local officials, and even more members of Congress. However, despite this progress, the social effects of enslavement and segregation and their continuing economic implications have largely been ignored by mainstream analysis until Coates' well-received analysis in the Atlantic magazine. These economic issues are the root cause of many critical issues in the African American community today, such as education, health care, and crime. The call for reparations represents a commitment to enter a constructive dialogue on the role of slavery and racism in shaping present-day conditions on our community and American society. H.R. 40 is designed to broaden the effort to educate the public by establishing a national commission to examine the institution of slavery. The commission would study the impact of slavery and continuing discrimination against African Americans, resulting directly and indirectly from the period of enslavement during the apartheid of Reconstruction, desegregation, and the present day. The commission would also make recommendations concerning any form of apology and compensation to begin the long-delayed process of atonement. And when I use the term compensation, I do not mean money. I'm not talking about dollars and cents. While the commission will not erase the past, it can bring us closer to racial reconciliation and advancement. A commission would not only examine the institution of slavery, but the legacy of slavery that weighs so heavily on all of us, really, in this country. Anyone watching the civic protests in Ferguson can understand that while the shooting of Michael Brown was, of course, tragic, it is a part of a deeper problem facing our community. This reality is the result of the social, economic, and political disenfranchisement that people of color have endured throughout our experience in this country. And I look forward to today's discussion as being important so that we may identify a strategy or several that will bring us closer to the enactment of H.R. 40. While the rollback of Section 5 of the Voting Rights Act, a historic piece of civil rights legislation, I believe this conversation is even more relevant now than it ever was. And so I now, with great pleasure, turn this panel over to our moderator, my good friend, Dr. Ron Daniels, who serves as the president of the Institute of the Black World 21st Century, a longtime reparations activist in his own right, who who brings both an American and global perspective to this issue. Let's welcome him.
First and foremost, let's give a rousing round of applause to Congressman John Conyers. Congressman John Conyers, who has been courageous and honest looking for so many years. We want to move expeditiously in terms of this panel. First of all, I want to quickly make some acknowledgments. We want to acknowledge, certainly, Ambassador Rhonda King, who is the ambassador to the UN from St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Ambassador Prince, who is the ambassador to the United States at the embassy here in Washington. Mm-hmm. There are others from the Diplomatic Corps. I need to get the cards. I think I recognize from Antigua, I think. See, I remember you. I'm from big in Antigua. But I'll have to get the names, and we'll get the names, and we'll get those out in just a minute. So we know that there are some who gathered for this occasion. We're honored also that Dr. Julius Garvey is at the house. Dr. Garvey, would you please stand up here and recognize? One of Black America's and the world's most progressive and staunch theologians and pastors and a whole bunch more. The Reverend Dr. Frederick Haynes is in the house. Would you please hear? And his lovely wife and partner is also in the house. I think Susan Taylor. Is Susan still here? I know Susan will. If she's not, she will be here. But Kepa Burns is here. He is the other half, or probably, well, the other half. Kepa Burns, please stand and be recognized. Immediate past president of the Association of Black Psychiatrists of America, Nana Pat Newton is in the house. Katrina Brown, who is, some of you a couple of years ago, saw this remarkable film called Traces of the Trade, a really powerful film. Katrina Brown is also here, and Joseph Edwards, who is a playwright, has a play on Broadway that called Man-Child in the Promised Land, but even more equally important is working on a new play on reparations. Joseph Edwards. Is it Edwards? Did I say Edwards? Is it Edwards or Edwards?
Edwards.
Oh, all right. He's up. Give him a round of applause. We're delighted also quickly to acknowledge some folks with the Institute of the Black World 21st Century. I have to acknowledge my wife. I won't be able to go home. Mary Frances Daniels is in the house. Right here. And the Black Family Summit model, Leonard Dunston. Rosalind Hugh Home. And the wife of our esteemed Director of Communications, Karen Rojas, as well. And we'll make other recognitions as we move. Well, brothers and sisters and friends, let me just open by saying that some of you were here last year, when in fact it was a question of whether we should even continue these questions, these discussions about reparations. I was asked to receive the call, and I said, well, of course we should continue these conversations. But we don't have conversations for the sake of having conversations. The question that was posed is, what is new? What is it that will drive the conversation on reparations forward? We said there were two things. One, there was a new kind, it wasn't new, we just discovered, because there's so much to King. He's very deep. There was a piece on reparations, a quote that we had never heard before,
right,
in which he talks about reparations. He doesn't say reparations. He gives the rationale for it, the background for it, and he says, we're off to Washington to get our check. The other, however, was a startling new development, that the Caribbean nations, all of them, had come together to demand reparations for genocide and native genocide and African enslavement. Not one of them, not two of them, not the radical ones, not the conservative ones, all of them had come together to demand reparations for native genocide and African enslavement. This was a phenomenal development. So we said, last year, put together a little plan. We said, well, we're going to go around the country and do some things. One of which was to say we'll have some fora and invite the Prime Minister of St. Vincent and the Grenadines, the Honorable Dr. Ralph Gonzalez, who has been spearheading this effort, to come and be a part of the forum. He said he would do that. So we went to Chicago, and unfortunately he was not able to come, but he sent a very able representative who's here with us today. And we had and the Honorable Congressman John Conyers there, Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan. We had this incredible forum on April 17th, I guess it was, in Chicago, which was seen by thousands of people all across the world, and began to help provide some new energy to the movement, because at the end of the day, what are the developments that will provide that kind of energy? And then, out of the blue or black, we picked up the Atlantic magazine, and this is incredible piece by a brother whose father, many of us who are my generation know, but he said, I've been watching him on television and everything, and he's a bad brother, it's all that. Incredible piece on the case for reparations.
Right.
By Brother Ta-Nehisi Coates, who's with us here today. So, we have faith that we're on the verge of revitalizing and energizing the reparations movement in this country, and there are all kinds of reasons why that need be done that I will not cover. We're going to move now to our presenters. We have some very, very, very special guests who are here with us today. And I'm going to ask Don Rojas to come. And Don Rojas is our Director of Communications. He's the former editor of the Amsterdam News. He was Director of Communications for the NAACP. Also General Manager of WBAI New York. But most importantly for us, he was the Press Secretary for Maurice Bishop of the People's Revolutionary Government of Grenada. And that is an incredible